Hi there, this is JR from the RV Corral, and I got another fine coach to show you today. My phone number is 541-972-0825. If you have a question about this video or any of my other videos, just give me a call, I'd be happy to help you out. Now, what we've got here, and we're at our new Coburg lot right now, I've got this one out here at our Coburg lot, is a 29VE Winnebago Vista. Winnebago is a fantastic manufacturer. They make great coaches. And this Vista is an excellent, excellent example of one that's very easy to kind of get into the hobby in. This is a great place to start. So I want to take a look at some of these outside features first, and then we'll take a peek inside. One of the first things I want to point out is you got a nice big awning outside on this one. This is all push-button electric stuff. You're going to operate it from the inside. Very simple, easy to use. Now, that's important because on this particular coach, you have several elements of entertainment out here that you're going to be able to use under this awning. And you've also got this great storage space. It comes with an Aussie grill, okay, and it's got plenty of storage under here, an actual pass-through that goes to the other side. And as we work our way back here, you'll see you got a little more storage. You've got your inverter down here as well. And then you've got a TV right out here. Really easy to use. If you want to pull this strap right here, it pops right out. You can turn that so you can let everybody get a good view, that kind of thing. And then you've got this great outdoor kitchen. So really under this awning, with this TV, with the grill that they're giving you here, and with this outdoor kitchen, you have a great entertaining space. Now I got another RV parked here, so I can't open it more for us, but you've got fantastic roll doors on this cabinetry in here, really nice, and back here as well. This has got a refrigerator in it. This has got hot and cold water at the sink. So this is just like a sink inside. You've got that full utility out here. And you've got a plug-in. So if you wanted to use a blender to mix some drinks out here, maybe you've got some other piece of equipment that you're using, you've got access to that right there. So this pull-out right here gives you a place to throw your cutting board, somewhere to store some dishes and whatnot out here. You got a couple more pieces of cabinetry down here that you can use as well. And then to kick it all off, you've got a cooler back here with a drain. So if you fill this up with ice and you throw a few drinks in there, when all that ice melts, you just pull the drain. It's going to drain right out. It's fantastic. Now, the grill, of course, where are you going to put the grill? You're going to put the grill right back here because you have your gas outlet conveniently located at the rear of the coach right beside this outdoor kitchen area. So between that grill and everything you find inside of there, you got a really nice outdoor kitchen area here. This is a great tailgater. You go to the game, you entertain, you make a few steaks, burgers, you have everything that you need here. Now, since we're back here, there's a couple of features here that are real nice. This has got a backup camera on it. If you're familiar, a lot of your cars nowadays are going to have backup cameras on them as well. Really convenient way to see what's behind you, be safe, make sure you're not going to back into anything. And a lot of folks might be uncomfortable with the idea of using a Class A coach. This camera is going to give you a little bit more of an assurance that you're not going to run over something. It's going to make it a little bit easier for you to enjoy using it. Got your tow receptacle down here. This is a 5,000 pound tow hitch here. You've got your plug-in for your lights and whatnot. You can tow your car behind this. You can pull a trailer with the quads. You know, whatever's going to be convenient. Heck, you can use that receptacle and put a rack in here and throw some bikes back here. Whatever suits your different style of camping. Now, you've got to, if you need to get up on the top, check, maybe you dragged a branch or something like that. Maybe you just like to make sure that everything's in order. This one does have a ladder on here. You can climb up here and you can take a look at the roof. Now, this is, all these Winnebago products have an actual fiberglass roof on them. So, you know, some products are not going to have that. This is going to last for a really long time. It's going to be a part of the coach that ensures that you don't have to worry about something, you know, and they're known for how good the quality of these are. Now, as we slide on down to the other side, you'll see, I'm just going to kind of open them up. We've got a lot of storage down here. We've got a lot of utilities. Your 4,000 watt generator is right back here. Now, that's a quiet gen. This is much quieter than you'll find older stuff would have been. You've got your power connection is going to be in here. Fuel door here. A little bit more storage with a full pass through there. look down here, you'll see a really, what I love about Winnebago is kind of the clean and modern style of things. This is a nice, clean, efficient station for your waste. You know, you've got access to an inlet for your fresh water there. You got your black tank flush. You got your drains for your gray and your black tanks. You got a light in there. And all of this conveniently pops through right down here, just like that. So you got a place for every hose to go right through there. And when this is in use, you pop that back and your compartment's nice and sealed up. So, and there, that's the other side of that big pass-through we were looking through earlier. You know, just a really considerable amount of space, especially for such a small gas coach. You know, for a lot of people these days, if it's not 35 feet long, it's not really big. You know, so your propane is right down here. I'll kind of show you a little bit of that sort of thing. Now, there's a couple of things I especially like about Winnebago. One of those things is a still cage in the front of this. This coach has a still cage built around the front of it. It's got steel. You can feel it underneath there. The firewall in this is all metal. This is going to give you a layer of protection if you were to get into a collision. That's hard to find in other places. They actually seal their windshield in, just like in an automotive situation. All of the new designs for these Winnebagos, they literally pick these up with a crane, flip it over, and then drop it, and then they go inside to make sure the appliances didn't fly around. All your appliances are bolted into steel. All of your TV arms and whatnot, those are going to be connected to something in the wall that's steel. There's a level of construction and safety measures in a Winnebago that are going to be hard to find in other products. And that makes them one of my favorites by far. So let's step around the front here. Real attractive cap on this guy. Looks very good in the front. And I think we're going to go ahead and take a look inside now. Okay. So you'll notice your cockpit in this immediately when you step in. You know, both of these chairs are gonna spin around for you. So if that's a thing that you want to do, you want to have the convenience of being able to spin these around and use them as a, you know, part of the living room, you can do that. You've got your Pioneer system up here for your entertainment, for your rear view camera that you're going to route your GPS through, you know, and you've got a lot of nice controls in this cockpit too. Very comfortable looking and a nice molded dashboard here with a finished look instead of something that just has a lot of pieces overlaid to give it a finished look. It's an actual finished look. You've got power leveling over here, and this is auto leveling, so you can just press a button and be done if you like, you know. So as we look back over here into the living space, there's a couple of things to note. You've got a pretty nice couch in here, pretty spacious. That's going to be really convenient. And you've got your chairs there, so up to four people can kind of sit in that area to be entertained. You got your dinette here. Now both this dinette and this couch are going to break down and make a sleeping space for you. So, you know, you got a couple of people visiting, those are going to be a real convenient place for sleeping. And you've also got up here your TV mounted on the wall. Now what I like about this one mounted on the wall over here is it gives you a lot of options. You can watch from the chairs over there, you can watch from the couch over here. And you might ask yourself, you see this floating out here, well, where do I keep my entertainment equipment? Where do I put my DVD player? Hey JR, I want to bring a VCR with me. I'm not one to judge, and these guys have been great about giving you a really nice component location in this. And you'll see this in a lot of the new Winnebago products. You can put several components in here. They're going to all be routed. You can make sure that they're going to the proper TV and whatnot. You want a PlayStation up here. You want a DVD player. No problem. You can do that. And then when you're not using it, tucks up out of the way. Lock it to make sure it's not going anywhere. So a lot of storage in here too. You've got some really nice overhead storage, both over the dinette here, as well as over the couch. So that's pretty nice. pretty well lit underneath the counter here. I really like that between the backsplash too, this little backsplash they've got, the border, nice reflection in there, and just really considerable amount of space in your cabinetry for dishes and whatnot. You know, really nice. Nice stainless steel finishes here, which is a very pleasant thing. And once again, you've got a lot of cabinetry here. Big pots and pans drawer. Huge complaint that I hear out of people with some older designs is they don't have a pot and pan drawer that's good enough. They put it all in the oven. Well, we want you to make something in your oven. Let's keep your pots and pans down here. You know, this guy is equipped with just a regular microwave here because it's got the oven as well as the stovetop. Now, while we're over here, I want to kind of spin around and take a look at the cockpit again, because there's a great feature. It's the loft bed. It's super quick, super smooth action. A lot of people are really amazed that it just comes down that rapidly, you know, and you can set it to go a little bit lower than that, but it comes with a ladder that's going to hook up on there. You know, if you need to, it also has a net to put up so the kiddos don't roll out of it if you've got kiddos staying in there or something like that. So just super convenient, really nice thing. Now we're going to take a look back here and kind of finish up with the kitchen. Gas electric refrigerator here. You got a Norcold unit. Got a pretty good size here, 8 cubic feet, pretty considerable. And then you got a nice bit of cupboard space here. This is food storage, a little bit of extra space over here. And really does the trick in a kitchen like this. Now, we'll kind of flip around here and take a look in the bathroom. And Winnebago does a great job on their bathrooms, and I like this one especially. There's a really nice size shower in here, you know, and of course this is lockable, so it doesn't flop around when you're driving. Got a skylight in here with plenty of headroom just in case somebody needs it. And then, you know, you got a lot of other utilities in there, storage space and whatnot. And the thing I like about it is, you know, you're not knees against the wall. This has got enough space to be used appropriately. Now, here in this bathroom, we got a nice double pocket door here. It's going to slide out, going to give you all the privacy you need, and still give you a walk-around bed. So, you know, you've got a nice private spot with plenty of ventilation and a walk-around bed back here, if that's what you would like. Nice space in the closet here. Just a whole lot of clothing storage could be accomplished in here, as well as, you know, your drawers below that. So really a nice space if you're trying to carry plenty of clothing with you, maybe have some extended stays or whatnot. Now, and I like this one because usually they don't flip up like this, but this TV actually flips up, which I like a lot, giving you a considerable amount of storage space back here as well. And that's one of the nice things about our modern TVs in these, is that we get more storage space. So, queen size walk-around bed, as I mentioned. There is a step up over here, so if the bed's too high for you, you don't have to pole vault into it. More clothing space on the side here if you need it. And I really like this one. Not a lot of people do it this way. You got a nice cubby here tucked back, and then you have power in the back of it. And you've got one on both sides here. If you've got to use a CPAP machine, maybe you just want to charge your phone at night, you know, you've got some space to do that, and you've got a plug-in. And you got some nice reading lights under here too. Once again, storage everywhere. Everywhere you look, you know, there's just a lot of storage in this unit. So you got a max fan in the bedroom here too, so that's going to give you some great ventilation. And you know, as far as the bed itself goes, you're also going to have this storage underneath it. So, I mean, you're not going to lack for storage in this. It's going to be a great unit for that. And, you know, really a considerable floor space. One of the things, I don't know if you've noticed as you've watched this video or not, but this is a single slide unit. You've got a full wall slide on this thing going from the front to the back. Why is that good, you say? Well, you know, when you have multiple slides, you have multiple slides to operate. With a single slide like this, they've created an enormous amount of room in this unit. And the great thing is, even with the slide in, because it's so long, they keep it pretty shallow. They don't want it hanging off the side of the coach too far. you really have enough room to get to everything in here. You can get to your bathroom, you can get to your bed, you can get to your refrigerator, you can use your entire kitchen. So if you pull over at a rest stop on the side of the road somewhere, you can still use all these things. You don't have to pull over at a park and put your slide out just to make yourself a sandwich. So there's a lot of utility in this coach. This is a V10 Ford engine, of course, and you know, if you're ready to take a test drive, if you like what you see in this video, I just want to remind you again, my number is 541-972-0825, JR. Give me a call down here at the RV Corral in Coburg, and we'd be happy to answer all your questions. Please watch my other videos as well, share them with your friends, and if there's anything I can help you with, please give me a call, 541-972-0825. Have a good day.
I bought my Winnebago through the RV Corral because these guys have been serving the state of Oregon and Lane County since 1988.
I bought my Winnebago because of the 50-year tradition of excellence that drives the RV market.
Well, ultimately, I bought because of the great service and help I was given.
I still purchase mine because of their tradition.
Service.
Tradition.
Service.
Tradition.
I guess we can both agree RV Corral is Eugene's number one dealer.